हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। आई एम मनदीप सिंह ठाकुर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट चंडीगढ़ पॉलिटेक्निक कॉलेज गुड़गांव। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी आर स्टडीड अबाउट द स्टीम पावर प्लांट एंड देयर एडवांटेज एंड डिसएडवांटेज, एंड आल्सो वी आर स्टडीड द सिलेक्शन साइट सिलेक्शन ऑफ स्टीम पावर प्लांट। In this lecture, we are studying about the hydropower project or hydropower plant. How we can install a hydropower project and the generation comes from the hydropower project. Let us start with the PPT. Here we go. Hydropower plant. This picture shows the project detail about hydropower project. In hydropower plant, when we select a hydropower plant, there are some points discussed: essential elements, introduction, hydropower plant in India. Essential elements of hydropower plant, diagrammatical working of hydropower plant, advantages, disadvantages, and selection of site for hydropower plant. We discuss all these points in this lecture. Let's start with introduction. In hydropower plant, the water is utilized to move the turbines, which in turn run the electric generators. Means the production of electricity is start with the help of prime mover, which is moved by hydro turbines. The potential energy of the water stored in the dam gets converted into the kinetic energy of the dam of the moving water in the penstock, and this kinetic energy gets converted into electrical energy with the help of turbine and generator combination. And after that, the transmission of electricity is started. Hydropower plants are invented by H.F. Rogers, the engineer or scientist which the founder of or invented the hydropower plant. Firstly, the hydropower plant fulfills the 30% of the total energy needs of the world. Means it is a major part which we utilize the natural source. Total hydro potential of the world is about 5,000 gigawatt. Now, the history of the hydropower plant and the hydropower plant situated in India. First hydropower plant was constructed at Mysore in 1902, named as Sivaramudram, having capacity 4.5 megawatt. Second hydropower plant was constructed at Maharashtra in 1914, named as Khopolo, having capacity about 50 megawatt. Hydro potential of India in 1947 is 500 megawatt. It is a general information and basic information about hydropower plant and the history, how the hydropower project started. These are some essential elements of hydropower plant. Primary elements: the catchment area, the surrounding area from where the water is extracted. Reservoir. Reservoir is the place there the water is stored. Dam. The next one is dam. Dam is a wall of concrete which hold the water in the reservoir. Next one is prime movers. Prime movers which starts initial movement with the help of water, which is called turbines. Draft tubes. Draft tubes are the tubes which is used to when the plant undergoes the breakdown or repair and maintenance work. Powerhouse and equipment. Powerhouse, here the generation took place and the accessory safety devices. Safety devices are spillways, standby ways, surge tank for the control the flow of water, and trash rack. Trash rack are the empty racks or during rainy season, heavy rainfall, save the our plant or a driving unit, turbine and generator set from tear and wear. Let us start the main parts of hydropower station and these essential elements one by one. Explain one by one. The first one is catchment area. The whole area behind the clam draining into a stream as a river across which the dam has been built at suitable place is called catchment area or the surrounding from where the water is extracted. The next one is reservoir. A reservoir is employed. A reservoir is employed to store water, which is further utilized to generate power by running the hydroelectric turbines. This is the basic requirement of a hydroelectric plant. The purpose of the reservoir is to store water during the rainy season because there is wide variations in water supply from a river or canal. So it becomes necessary to store water by constructing a dam in order to ensure the generation of power throughout the year. The stored water can be supplied to the turbines during dry season and also according to the load on the power plant. So, reservoir is a basic requirement of any kind of hydropower plant project. Dam. Dam is a barrier which confines or raises water for storage or diversion to create a hydraulic head. Dams are generally made of concrete, stone, masonry, rock fill, or timber. A dam is a ball built up of concrete or stone, earth or rock fills. The type of arrangement depends upon the topography of the site. The masonry dam may be built in a narrow canyon. An earth dam may be best suited for a wide valley. The type of dam also depends upon the foundation conditions, local materials and transportation available, occurrence of earthquakes and other hazards. And the next one is turbine generator TG combination. Turbine generator combination. The turbine and generator is the most important part of any power plant. This combination is known as the heart of the power plant. Turbine. Turbine is a very light fan like structure having many numbers of blades. It has an ability to rotate on its axis when water passes through it. And the next important element is generator. Generator is a device in which when there is a rotation of coil between the strong magnetic field, then it produces an alternating current or AC current. This is the basic diagram of inside a hydropower plant. We can see that in the reservoir, there are lots of water stored. And after that, a dam is constructed to store the water at a suitable height. A dam is like a concrete wall. It holds the water which is stored in a reservoir. As we see, the intake process of the reservoir, it is called head or intake. The control gate ensures the flow of water to the penstoke. Penstoke is a way to water which on a control rate which further moves the turbine. The turbine is connected to or coupled to a generator, which when generator moves, it produces electricity. So the potential energy, which is firstly converted into kinetic energy or flow of water, and further that, by the movement of turbine, the generator produces the electricity. And this, the production of electricity further with the help of transformer, we can step up this production of electricity and transmit the energy to the powerhouse to long transmission line, through the long transmission line. After the movement of the turbine, after the movement of turbine, the water comes to river with the help of outflow or trail race. Draft tube, it is also the essential element. Draft tube is an empty structure made beneath the turbine. It serves in the following two main purposes. The first one is it allows the turbine to be set above tailwater level without loss of head to facilitate inspection and maintenance. It regains by diffuser action the major portion of the kinetic energy delivered to it from the runner. It increases the output power. It also increases the efficiency of hydropower plant. Penstoke. Penstoke is the connecting pipe between the dam and the turbine house. It helps to increase the kinetic energy of the water coming from the dam. Penstoke is made of a very strong material which can sustain the high pressure of the water. These are some powerhouse and equipment belong to powerhouse. The first one is some more components are required for proper user friendly and smoothly function of the power plant. These components are number one, valve. This is the instrument which is used to control the pressure of flow of water. And the second one is pumps. This device is used to send water or any fluid from lower potential to higher potential. The next one is spillways. Spillways is a kind of canal provided besides the dam spillways is used to arrange the excess of accumulation of water on the dam, because excess accumulation of water may damage the dam construction. And the next one is surge tank. When there is a sudden close or decrease in pressure due to control valve, then there is a backflow of water. This creates a high pressure zone in the penstock due to which it may burst. This effect is known as water hammering effect. To avoid this, a tank is attached to the penstock which stores water in it. This tank is called as surge tank. Let us start with the working of hydropower plant. Initially, the water of the river is in catchment areas. From catchment area, the water flows to the dam. At the dam, the water gets accumulated. Thus, the potential energy of the water increases due to the height of the dam. When the gates of the dam are open, then the water moves with high kinetic energy into the penstock. Through the penstock, water goes to the turbine house. Since the penstock makes water to flow from high altitude to low altitude, thus the kinetic energy of the water is again raised. Initially, the water of the river is in, so it is the all about the working of the hydropower project. Let us start the advantage and disadvantage of hydropower project, of hydropower plant. Here we go. The first advantage is no fuel charges, because there is no fuel utilized. So the running cost of the power station is less as no fuel is used. And the second one is less supervising staff is required. As per the diagram or the working, the construction and working of the hydropower plant is very simple. So less supervising staff is required. The maintenance and operation charges are very low because of hydro plant's operation. It is quite simple. Therefore, the running cost of the power plant is low. The running costs includes the maintenance, the manpower, and the charges to use the fuel. So all these are low. Therefore, equivalent, the running cost of the power plant is low. The next advantage is the plant efficiency does not change with age because there is low tear and wear of the plant. The next advantage is it takes few minutes to run and synchronize the plant. And the next one is no fuel transportation is required because there is no fuel which we use to rotate the turbine. No ash and flue gases problem and does not pollute the atmosphere because there is no fuel combustion. These plants are used for flood control and irrigation purpose also. Long life in comparison with the thermal and nuclear power plant. As compared to thermal power plant and nuclear power plant, the hydropower project has a long life because there is no combustion took place. As per the advantages, as well as there are some disadvantages of this power plant. Let us start with first disadvantage. The initial cost of the power plant is very high the initial cost of power plant is very high because of construction of dam. Takes long time for construction of dam. It also a disadvantage. It took to construct many years. And generally, such plants are located in hilly areas, far away from load center, and thus they require long transmission lines, and losses in them will be more. As we see, the long transmission lines have more losses. So it is also a disadvantage. And the next one is, the power generation by hydropower plant is only dependent on natural phenomena of rain. Therefore, at the time of drought or summer session, the hydropower plant will not work. The reason behind this is there is no adequate level of water, or no heavy flow to run the hydro project. These are some advantages and disadvantages about the hydropower project. Let us start with the site selection. Selection of site. The following factors should be considered while selecting the site for hydroelectric power station. The first one is sufficient quantity of water at a certain height is available. Adequate transportation facility is required to the up and down to heavy equipments to the site. The next one is possibility of stream diversion during construction period. Possibility of construction a dam to store the water at least possible cost. Reservoir must have a large catchment area so that level of water in the reservoir may remain above the minimum required in dry season. The land should be cheap in cost and rocky so that it holds the weight or mass of the dam. Thank you. If you have any query about this lecture, you may feel free to ask. Thank you.